What's good? Bo back at you with another video. Today, we're going to be discussing all the things coming with the Shadowlands pre-patch. I would like to start things off saying I'll be covering spoilers related to the story with the upcoming Scourge invasion, so you have been warned beforehand if you would like to stop watching now. First thing you'll notice is that your character has been scaled down. Yes, the level squish will be in place and all level 120 characters will be scaled down to level 50. Wowhead has a nice table determining what level you'll be scaled down to if you are not level 120, which I will leave a link for down in the description. Leveling with the squish should be easier now, about 50 to 60% faster now than how long it takes to get to 120 now. You can choose to level in any expansion you like after you reach level 10. My personal favorite expansion to level in is probably the Burning Crusade, because that's when I really started to play and I think the quests and all the zones are pretty enjoyable and straightforward. New players will be forced to level through BFA, which is a huge slap to the face, because imagine being forced to level in BFA when there were just so many better expansions. But I'm just memeing though, I really didn't mind BFA. I think they're just doing this so they can be caught up with the story and how it ties into Shadowlands. I think new player will be defined as anyone who doesn't already have a level 120, so you might want to level now if you don't have one. That way you just have more player choice when it comes to leveling. Corruption will also be out of the question. It'll be completely grayed out on your gear if you do check, but if you have really good gear, you probably won't end up replacing this gear till around level cap. Azerite gear and essences won't work in Shadowlands. They will only work unless you're on Azeroth specifically. New talents and gameplay changes will also be in for your respective classes. Keep in mind, some abilities won't be at their full power or have their added effects until we're able to level past 50. Kind of sucks, but it is what it is. Like, I won't be able to have Furious Gaze until level 58, which actually blows, but at least DHs are going to be getting it now, right? Also, the AoE cap of 5 targets will be in place for most abilities to slow the gameplay down or get rid of this degenerate play style of pulling everything at once from Ian accordingly. But honestly, they should have just made mobs themselves more difficult rather than just nuking our AoE. Getting off topic here, but I think it's kind of dumb that this is actually a thing now. But it is what it is. Maybe you guys think differently, so let me know. Scourge Invasion will also be taking place. Players will remember this event similar to how it was during the Dark Portal opening and before the release of Wrath. This event seems different to how I remember it back in Wrath. All I pretty much remember is that I got some sick looking transmog that resembled the Judgment scent from killing zombies, and it was like a nice turquoise or like teal color, but I don't remember turning into an actual zombie during this event. I personally don't understand the appeal of this event now. You just turn into a zombie around cities and get a separate action bar. The only real reason for wanting this is to turn others into a zombie with your abilities. It seems fun for like 5 minutes and then it just becomes annoying, and I think most people try to avoid it. There will also be a quest chain available involving the Scourge. The intro quest will differ for Alliance and Horde, but the general idea of the questline is you gather intel, defeat some Scourge, and are then sent to Icecrown. In Icecrown, if you look up, there's a hole in the sky reminiscent of the Shadowlands trailer. For the first week of this quest chain, you will do some more quests and ultimately establish a foothold. Scourge and Icecrown will have a chance to drop Scourge Stones, which you can use for reputation with the Argent Dawn. I think the dailies also reward you with some stones as well, but I'm not entirely sure. After the second week, you'll be able to access more of this quest chain. Essentially, you'll find out about the Jailer and the Maw and learn the reason as to why the Scourge have made an appearance again. Once that's taken care of, you will get access to more dailies and a portal that leads directly to the Argent Tournament grounds from your faction's major capital city. There'll also be some rares throughout Icecrown you can kill for loot that resemble gear from previous tiers during Wrath. This gear is super nice for alts, as will be item level 100, which is the equivalent to like normal level Nihilotha. This is great if you may be trying to gear for Shadowlands with a freshly made alt. Overall, this event is just nice for catching up undergeared alts and setting up the portal to Icecrown for easy access to the Argent Tournament dailies for all the racial mounts you can get from there. There's some other cool things we can do during this pre-patch event. You'll finally be able to kill Nathanos. Man is literally just chilling at his home place for you to kill him. There's even a world quest to show his location. He drops Warfront looking gear, but I'm not exactly sure what his entire loot table is going to be. One thing I'm super excited for is all the new customizable options coming to us. You'll be able to see all these options at the character creation screen and at the barbershop. Plus, the animations for when you pick a class look a lot better. I definitely think this will be more appealing to new players who aren't sure what class they want to be, and the preview for each is a nice option they added. Lastly, the new Exile's Reach starting zone will also be out. This is just a new starting area for new characters within the level 1 to 10 range. However, you can still choose to level in the original starting zones for that respective race if you wish. You start off on this ship and then end up going to an uncharted island looking for a previous dispatched crew from whom you haven't heard back yet. There's going to be a dynamic help system in place for new players to help guide them through the basics of the game and the core abilities of their class. As you progress through the island, you'll end up in a mini dungeon with two bosses that you'll need to kill. There's no roll requirements for this dungeon, and it scales according to your group. Overall, some good things coming with the pre-patch. We are going to be losing a lot of power just because we're losing corruption. Let me know what you're most hyped for or not hyped for down in the comments below. But that's going to be it for this video. Leave a like if you did like the video. Subscribe to the channel if you're new here for more content. But until next time, dudes, peace.